Mike Forsberg is on a mission.
Well, that's different.
He's a nationally renowned photographer, conservationist, and author.
You walk into a place like this that's never been plowed or tilled, you can just feel it. It's a different feel, it's got a different spirit to it.
For 4 years, he's been trekking 100,000 miles across all 12 states of the Great Plains. His goal is to portray a surprising diversity of wildlife and plant species in a region often overlooked as flyover country. And his images fill a new book, Great Plains, America's Lingering Wild.
I want people to understand that there's something out there. It's not one big flat cornfield. It's not a place that you drive through necessarily at 80 miles an hour or fly over at 30,000 feet. It's a place that has tremendous value, tremendous beauty.
It's late January. Mike is visiting the Sandhills, a sea of grass-covered sand dunes that stretch across the western expanse of Nebraska. At Blue Creek Ranch, Mike is joined by University of Nebraska hydrologist Jim Gecki and ranch manager Alan O'Borney. As he's done for more than a decade, Mike attempts to photograph elusive trumpeter swans near the Crescent Lake National Wildlife Refuge.
They land into the wind, so they should be landing right into the face of the blind.
At this time of year, most of the lakes throughout the Sandhills are frozen over. During milder seasons, these lakes provide important breeding, nesting, and feeding habitat for a wide range of birds. But while all the lakes are frozen, there's just one source of open water, Blue Creek. Blue Creek is spring-fed by the largest underground source of water in the entire Great Plains, the Ogallala Aquifer. It stretches from South Dakota to Texas, lying beneath nearly two-fifths of the Great Plains. The relationship between the underground water of the aquifer and the surface water of Blue Creek is the reason Mike returns here year after year.
It's an exciting time to be a photographer.
The Sandhills region is an ancient landscape.
A lot of stories to tell here.
Yeah, yes. Obviously, you know, it came from up here. This part of the world was populated by camels at one time.
For thousands of years, the Sandhill dunes were continually shaped by wind and drought until vegetation took hold.
Most of the Sandhills, by current estimates, have been in place and modified in the last 10,000 years, which geologically makes it a very dynamic area.
Thousands of years ago, moving dunes dammed off parts of Blue Creek, and Crescent Lake was formed.
My guess is that those waters are several thousands of years old at a minimum. We have drilled test holes, and those waters down about 750 feet dated out at about 12,000 years old.
The Ogallala Aquifer is a complex water system. Unlike an underground lake or river, an aquifer is made up of layers of stone, gravels, and sands that allow water to pass through.
There's a real element to mystery about how these things function, because you need a confining layer and you need a hydraulic head. The hydraulic head for this are the lakes and the impoundments of water up at Crescent Lake. And that provides the elevation difference that provides the pressure.
For most of the region, the waters of the Ogallala Aquifer remain confined underground, between the rock and sand layers. But here and there, water gets forced to the surface through seeps and cracks, forming springs.
A lot of times springs occur at contacts between different formations. Most of the springs we see in the Sandhills we refer to as boiling springs, not because they have any hot temperature, but they're really vigorous.
The aquifer system is vital to the existence of swans and other wildlife. The springs flow from the aquifer at a constant temperature of around 56 degrees.
In the depths of winter, you know, when everything else freezes over, the lakes freeze over, the creek still runs because of these powerful springs coming up from the Ogallala Aquifer. So these places are just, you know, these creeks are just magnets for waterfowl and wildlife in the wintertime.
Near Blue Creek, Mike has placed his photo blind to attempt to capture the trumpeter swans.
We're going to go down, and then we're going to come along this low swale and sort of angle up to the blind. These swans do something weird. If they start acting more out of the ordinary than they are now, then we're going to bag it.
As Mike approaches the blind, the birds get spooked. So Mike continues to the blind on his own, taking with him a small handheld video camera.
So this is the home away from home, the Sandhills Swamp Motel in the upper reaches of Blue Creek drainage in the Nebraska Sandhills. And this is my world for the next 12 hours or so, me and the ducks. They're coming in big waves now. They're all Canadas. There's several different subspecies of Canadas out here, and I'm waiting for trumpeter swans. Hopefully they'll come. It was noisy neighbors. The moon came up late, and as soon as that moon came up, birds started flying. Fly up and down river, you'd hear geese, and you'd hear swans, and you'd hear ducks. And that I've never seen before. Maybe that's something they do all the time. We're talking about history, we're talking about geology, we're talking about how, you know, how the Sandhills maybe were formed. We're talking about this huge, vast sponge of water that we're sitting on top of, and how groundwater is connected to surface water, and how all these creatures rely on this water to survive, how we rely on this water to survive, and how we use it. You know, this is really cool.
Continue exploring the science in our lives at netnebraska.org/quest.